because this is cyber security, that is computer genocide. Yes, so we shouldn't mix them up. So this is the course that we offer. It's a professional course. What do I mean by professional? That is being gotten from different accredited content in so many notable universities in Canada and in America. We have University of Laval, got some of our content from University of Laval, and we got some from Indiana University of Pennsylvania. So we are affiliates, you know, we are affiliated, so to say. And then we have so many other partners too, which much later I'll be taking you through them, just briefly. As I said earlier, we don't intend to waste your time. So without wasting your time further, I'd like to welcome my partner, Mr. Ademola Olajeja, to just welcome us into the main session where you'll be taking some of these courses. Before I call him up, we have 9 modules, cybersecurity. Please, I would like to share some stuff with you so that we won't just be blank. Sorry. So as I talked, I prefer to go through the committees. So then this seminar promises to be informative and educative, as well as fun-filled. Fun-filled in the sense that you'll be discovering so many things that you thought you knew, but you really actually didn't know. So, those are the courses, just go through them, so you don't get lost. So Mr. Ademola, please, can you come on the stage? Thank you.
Thank you
very much.
Good morning, gentlemen. I don't like what I'm saying here. Is it only that only men are interested in security issues? No, because she's the only female amongst us. I'm wondering why. Okay, let's see. What I'm here to do is to tell us some things we already knew and to add some things that maybe we thought we knew, but we knew it in a different dimension. And the first thing I would like to say is that security threat is real. We are made to believe that we are safe online. As long as you have your username and your password, you are safe. That is what we are made to believe, but it's completely wrong. And as humans, we are mostly, I was talking with someone not long from now, I said, we are mostly motivated when the event has occurred and we are looking for a solution. But when we are to protect ourselves, to prevent, we kind of take it with levity and say, well, I'll do it later, it's not that important. But it's a bad thing to experience a cyber threat, especially when you are in the middle of something very important. So it's better to avoid it. Now, all that we know about security, putting your password in a safe place, and also the sites you visit, the downloads, and other things. I don't know whether you read the blog. There's a blog post I did on cyber security. Is anybody here that read the blog post? Okay. So, such things are there, but there's some things that are internal that we need to consider. And there are two ways I see this. You can use this skill as an individual. Let's say I became a cybersecurity expert because I want to secure my career, I want to secure my business. For instance, there's something I've been working on the hard disk. I have a 1 terabyte hard disk. There are some programs I've written, there are some interactive trainings that I've created for the past 10 years. Now, if there's something that happens to my system and there is a malware that destroys all these files, it means it has destroyed my life's work. Or I have a website, an e-commerce website, I have a lot of traffic and I'm getting sales from this site. Something happens to the website and everything crashes, that would be a disaster. And to recover from that can take me years, because it's very easy to destroy things, but to build, it takes time. So that is the reason why this is important. In fact, I expect this audience to be more than this, because this is an issue that affects governments. It affects a lot of people, not only organizations and individuals. It affects the nation on its own. So we need to take this very seriously. And we have experts that are going to explain some of these tips that we can use to protect ourselves. And to be candid with you, it is impossible for anyone to learn everything about cybersecurity within 1.5 hours. It's impossible. So this is just a primer. And in the documents you have in your hand, you will see that we have different modules and we have different packages. Like package one is an introductory package, which gives us the awareness of cybersecurity, information assurance, what are they, what are the essential parts of it, and why do we need to study this particular course. Then the second package is more advanced. So what I'm saying is, this seminar will not tell you everything you need to know about cybersecurity. It's a primer that will allow you to know the essence of what you are paying for if you're eventually doing this course. Why am I paying? What am I paying for? The value of what you are doing. So this seminar is to give you the information and also to help you in making the best out of this course. Because there's a possibility of going for a training, and at the end of the training, you have a certificate and just keep it somewhere. You know, that's not this. You can use it as an individual. You can use it as a consultant. You enter through the doors of the business, I'm a cybersecurity expert, and this is what I can do for you. It's a way of boosting your credibility and boosting your certificates. There's only one simple thing that you need to add more to what you have that gives you edge above others. Just one thing. So it may be this. When you add this and it makes you have an edge above others, you have a lot to learn. This is not the end of cybersecurity. When you get this, you have more opportunities, more information. We invite you for more. Since you have shown your interest, there are people that registered for this training and they didn't come here. For UK, it means you are really interested. So for you to come and be a part of this training, any other opportunity like this that come up, we'll make sure you are notified and we'll share more information about this with you. Thank you for your time. I know that we have more people to talk and we have a limited time. So I want you to take notes. If you have a pen and a paper, all these tips, I want you to be taking notes. I believe the recording will be available on YouTube after this training. So we are going to stream the recording. But there's nothing like being there. So I'm happy that you are here. Thank you for coming. Thank you.
Well, we've heard that the next session is going to be the main seminar. And we would like to invite Mr. Charles Dede, instructor for the day. You're welcome.
Thank you.
Please let
section, you to build a career path and tell yourself, you know, in the next 5 years where you want to be. And not only that, you need to build a strategy on how to accomplish whatever, you know, objective is actually chosen as a section. Alright? So we're going to be dwelling more on the benefits, you see, why you need to be a cybersecurity expert today. this is what, 2015, right?
Yeah.
But we're now in 2012, we're now in 2008. This is 2015, okay? So why do you really need to be a cybersecurity expert to be? And what is the potential for income, for career growth, for, you know, really doing something satisfying in this time living? Everyone here is aware of the proliferation of the internet. Am I right or wrong?
Yeah.
Is there anybody here who has never, like, you know, gone on the internet for one reason or the other? If you haven't, you can raise your hand. Now, this same question, if I had asked it like 10 years ago, what would have been the response? We would see probably everybody's hands up, like, hey, I've never touched a computer, neither do I know what the internet is all about. But in association with this whole massive appreciation and growth of the internet in this country, so likewise the threats, yeah, come alongside it, right or wrong. When many of us are broke, we never used to worry about how strong the door lock is, but 90%, I remember back then, I used to keep the door open. I'll tell myself, the one coming is every day, Tom, and it's your job, guy, carry my chair, blah, 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 blah. But all the time, what happens? By then, you get your first 100,000 before you sleep. You check, right? 20 minutes later, you wake up again. Yeah? For those who are married, though, ask the wife, honey, are you sure you love that door? Yeah? In the same light, in today's world, as we begin to finance the wealth of the internet, we begin to see the business opportunities of the internet, we begin to see what it can actually offer us as a human society. What happens? We now have more people who are interested in, you know, what's happening in there? And that question, what's happening in there, has brought about what? Cyber what? Let me ask you a simple question. Who do you think is smarter? The thief or the owner of the house? Let's be honest with ourselves. Who is smarter?
The thief.
And why do you think the thief is smarter? Who can answer that question? Okay, you're go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, the owner of the house thinks he has secured.
No, you can sit down, you can sit down. Okay. No, hear you, no problem.
The owner of the house, in his mind, he has locked everywhere, he has secured anywhere, nobody can break through. He knows the locks and keys he has put.